Lo quiero ver bien.
Así que nada.
No creo que vayan a colocar el tema del del Tormenta del Sol, pero bueno, vamos a ver. También que quería ver quién lo presentaba, entonces verlo así todo apurado, no. Vamos a verlo bien. Así que aquí estamos. Future Game Show Summer Showcase. Que este sí es como un evento aparte que no está dentro de todos los juegos de Geoff Keighley y tal.
A ver.
Hello everybody and welcome to the Future Game Show Summer Showcase. My name is Britt Baron and I play Tifa Lockhart in the Final Fantasy VII Remake series. But for the next 90 minutes, the gloves are
off. Yo sabía que te
reconocía. Instead of wailing on Shinra troops, I'm here to deliver some video game news. Joining me on this quest through the trailer dungeon is the one and only Roger Clark. Howdy, Roger.
Howdy, Britt. Pleasure to be here. I'm Roger Clark, though you may know me best as the lovable rogue Arthur Morgan from Red Dead Redemption 2. We've got a hell of a show for you today. Packed to the brim with world premieres, developer presentations, and everything in between. So hitch up
Tifa
your
Lockhart. ¿Pudo haber sido Brianna White, que me hubiera vuelto loco? Que es Aerith. Pero bueno, ella también está bien.
Wishlist any of the games featured today on our dedicated Summer Showcase Steam page. To find it, just search Future Games Show on Steam.
Well, I think we've already hit our cowboy quip quota.
Así que no puedo hacer una pequeña pausa publicitaria porque básicamente arrancó así de una vez. Primer World Premiere, señores. Bueno, aquí siempre, en el Future Game, siempre agarran dos dobladores de juego y los meten ahí a presentarlo con la boca. Otra vez hicieron a Laura Bailey. En tiempo de cruzada. Ok, conviértete en un templario.
Serve your God with unyielding devotion. Uphold tenets of our order, forged in the crucible of faith. Walk the path of righteousness, guided by the light of divine purpose. Let not doubt cloud your spirit, nor darkness dim your resolve. Remain steadfast, for the journey is long and fraught with peril. For in the crucible of doubt, we find the strength to persevere. Let faith be your shield, and righteousness your sword.
Cruzada de templarios con animales.
Do not be afraid, for he is by your side, lighting your path through the darkness.
Bogdan's Cross. Vale.
That was your first look at Bogdan's Cross.
¿Por qué se ve tan mal? O sea, estos directos no tienen calidad. Son 1080p y se ve todo.
Be sure to add it to your wish list.
Next.
O sea, la cara de Brit se trata toda pixelada ahí.
A third person action RPG.
Ok, aquí es donde tienen que colocar el Metal Slug Tactics con su demo y el Tormenta Sol con su demo. Si no, qué tristeza. Sí, sinceramente, los dos juegos que están esperando no me lo van a colocar. No.
Perhaps because each nightfall feels like it might be your last.
A ver.
One thing remains constant. Nothing beats the thrill of excitement a new sunrise brings. It's these moments that give you the power to venture out and explore the uncharted.
Conquer. Juega solo.
Especially when shared with friends. For everything.
O junto con un amigo. Se divide la pantalla en dos. Bueno, split screen. Bien.
Gestiona. Found in having a place you can call home. A place to nurture and care for. Even when you believe your task is complete, there's always another island to chase. Another place that'll make it all feel like it's the first time.
Defiende. Básicamente tienes que crear tu aldea y tu vaina y después expandir.
I suppose that's something that comes with the job title, right?
El primer enano. Con demo disponible ahora en Steam.
First Dwarf is launching in early access on the 20th of June.
But if you can't wait till then, the developers just dropped a demo on Steam, so you can jump in right after the show.
Now it's time to dive into the brain-slick world of Nobody Wants to Die, a cyberpunk detective thriller powered by Unreal Engine 5.
Pero siento que mi voz está más baja de lo normal. No sé por qué. ¿Por qué está tan bajo esto, tío? O sea, me pasa que no quiero subirle mucho el micrófono.
From Critical Hit Games, and I'm the studio's community manager, and we are located in the beautiful medieval city of Wrocław in Poland. Right now, we are working on Nobody Wants to Die. It's a single-player interactive noir story set in a dystopian New York City. It's inspired by neo-noir films, black-and-white detective movies, art deco stylings, but set hundreds of years into the future. You will discover the world of New York in the year 2329, where immortality comes at a price that someone has to pay.
Pero con un elemento así noir de época. Curioso.
Choosing the perfect music and composer for this game was so important. It allows players to feel truly immersed in this world we have built. We're honored to be able to work with Mikołaj Stroiński to create an incredible soundtrack for Nobody Wants to Die. Our small team of 20 has been working hard on this game for the last 4 years, and our aim from the start was to deliver a great narrative and a graphical experience for players in our dystopian world.
Un mundo distópico,
the music helps us to shape
futurista,
the emotion
que
vuelan, to feel in each moment,
todo, pero tiene ese aspecto de carros de los
2329. Its melodic 30, and moody theme beautifully encapsulates 40, the noir essence of the game, setting the stage for an immersive noir experience like no other. We're so pleased
como
that
too
many of you watched our reveal trailer that we released a few months ago, and today we're excited for you to get a glimpse into some of Nobody Wants to Die's core settings, including Detective James Carr's apartment. What you're looking at here are exclusive in-game shots captured from our PC build. This is our vision of the future. You will experience the story of Nobody Wants to Die from a first-person perspective, through the eyes of Detective James Carr. Through our narrative, we wanted to explore the dangers of transhumanism and immortality. In a society where death is a distant memory, the lines of right and wrong start to get a bit blurry. We're planning to release Nobody Wants to Die later this year on Xbox Series XS, PlayStation 5, and PC on Steam. Thanks for watching, and enjoy the rest of the show.
No, hay demo de Nobody Wants to Die. Pero me gusta el concepto. Viene el 24 sin fecha.
Nobody Wants to Die is coming later this year. What's next, Brit?
Vamos a con Brit.
Brit! Brit! Interesting. I'm just gonna head backstage and see what's going on here.
Welcome to the world of Detective Dotson, Roger.
No sé si quisiera
it's an
hacer
adventure
un comedy
game set in
eso,
India
pero,
where you use disguise and parkour to track down your father's killer.
Sounds great. One question.
How ahora son Brit y el otro versión cartoony.
I'm not sure, but watching this new trailer can't hurt, right?
Mirar este nuevo tráiler no puede doler. Me hubiera gustado que hubiera empezado a hablar como Tifa. ¿Qué? Al punto de que hasta se... O sea, Brit y el otro se pusieron... Se hicieron como una presentación especial de ellos hablando con los gráficos de este juego. Así que, a saber. Detective Dustin.
Detective Dotson is coming to PC in 2024, and the developers just launched a demo for the game on Steam, so you can dive in after the show. While you're there, why not add it to your wish lists?
During this year's Spring Showcase, our hosts cracked open the Ones to Watch yearbook, spotlighting three of the most hotly anticipated games coming in 2024.
In keeping with that tradition, we've got another trio of games to share that should definitely be on your wish lists.
First on our list is Once Human. Let's throw it over to the developers so they can tell you more about this new weird survival shooter.
Once Human. Y creo que ya había escuchado de este
juego. Hello, Metas. Welcome to the mysterious world of Once Human. I'm Derek, the head of operation of Once Human.
Yesterday, we revealed that Once Human will launch on PC on the 9th of July 2024.
I'm very honored to introduce Once Human to both new and old friends today and bring you more exclusive news. Once Human is a post-apocalyptic overworld survival game where we'll take on the role as a meta, striving to survive in a world corrupted by stardust and exploring the enigmatic now-pop continent. You must fend off outraged creatures alongside other metas, reclaim the old world, and uncover the truth behind the apocalypse. Many have labeled us as the most anticipated survival game of 2024, and I will tell you what makes Once Human so you. Your adventure will unfold in a seamless overworld. You adventure through treacherous mountains, sandy beaches, foggy swamps, wild plains, rushing waterfalls, dark caverns, and mysterious underwater and frigid tundras. Your exploration will stretch the boundaries of your imagination. The diverse flora and fauna in the open world add more possibilities to your journey. Let's see what survival skills you've got. Hunting, fishing, and planting are all part of the experience. The influence of stardust has led to widespread mutations across the continent. Stay cautious of the mutated deviants and the fanatical cultists. As well as the areas shrouded
tercera
in deep form, and
the
riddle spots scattered across
además,
the land.
Medio las tobojas.
As you may know, what makes us different is our monster design. In Once Human, the enemies that you ever encountered might be something that you never seen before. Animal, a new species born from the influence of stardust, will pose one of your greatest threats. The Wanderer, a walking bug that roams the world with its searchlight, and the
Mora,
a monstrosity that resembles of an excavator, are just a few to watch out
for.
In the future, you will encounter even more cryptic creatures in the skies above and oceans below. Don't forget about the reptile entities. Some of them are packing giant Gatling guns, some look like massive trees, and others might even haunt your dreams. Back for luck, Metas. Did I mention that Once Human might be one of the most diverse open world survival games out there? You must eliminate threats in strongholds and dungeons for materials to craft your custom equipment. Plus, you can capture divisions from all over the world and use their special abilities to help you out. Rex is your chef. Nutcracker handles security, and the Kano Skull is a bodyguard. You can build your settlement anywhere in the overworld,
or
even create
tu
a mobile
sitio,
home. With over 4,000 metas in a
server,
watch out for ambushes and looting. Remember to forge alliance with others to build settlements and get it on 12 versus 12 compass for real.
Oh, tiene PvP.
And that's not all. Once Human is committed to providing unique and constantly updated content for players all over the world.
Cuidado.
We also aim to cater different players' preferences.
Curioso,
we've got seen the seasons and all kinds of challenges rolling out soon. These include
pero...
PvE world bosses and PvP content that encourages you
no
to pillage and plunder. But wait, there's more. We're also adding survival challenges
si
where meta
un,
must
o sea,
compete
si
for extremely
allí,
scarce resources.
Cosas, gente,
the creativity
tal,
of Once Human doesn't stop there. You can unleash your
entonces,
imagination by building island, a truly unique
okay, pero
internal land. Feel free to customize
eso, okay.
The island to your liking and even change the
o sea,
objective
ver
of
que,
the season
de qué trata
when you create
esto.
The world. and you bring it to life. Blasphemous for PC is coming your way on the 9th of July 2024.
El 9 de julio.
So don't forget to edit your Steam wishlist. On the 10th of June, we'll kick off the final round of open beta of Steam. Don't miss out the exclusive cosmetics on the first day.
The dolls
are now available. And you will want to miss the opportunity. Get ready to delve into the unknown. See you on the other side, Menace.
Bueno, no sé, pero básicamente el audio se cortaba cada rato. Como que la edición del video estaba corta, así.
You can play the Steam demo when it drops on June 10th next week.
And if you enjoyed that section, watch out for two more ones to watch
Once
deep
Human
dives
no está mal.
We've got another world
que,
premiere for no you
sé.
Now. It's a co-op game.
We have service, to synchronize que no your sé movements si to succeed. Pero creo que
Let's see it!
Oh, yes.
Whoa, right. Nice work! Yeah.
We're off on a magical adventure.
Pero bueno, el Once Human me llamó la atención hasta cierto punto, pero hay que ver.
I have a purple X. I guess if you hit that.
Oh, yeah, hay que ver.
Okay, can you move it across? Okay, and now send it all the way.
Hey. Oh. Okay, I'll jump then.
Ah, that opens a panel for me above the door.
Okay, what does it say, please?
We'll figure it out.
And bear in mind, if I get this wrong, it's just everything the other way around, okay?
Okay, I'll remember that.
Yeah.
Nice.
I will hit that.
Yo sigo diciendo que la E3 me hace falta.
Oh, very nice.
Porque la E3 era un evento muy interesante donde literalmente teníamos PlayStation, Xbox y Switch, Nintendo, perdón. Bloom. Y además estaba acompañado con otras como Square Enix, Ubisoft.
Wait, no, just the Explore.
EA, y como que eran las de esperada. Por ejemplo, aquí, ajá, Ubisoft va a hacer su evento solita por allá. PlayStation, Nintendo, Play, ahí medio ahí.
In sync.
Es que va a mañana.
It's coming
Nintendo
soon.
No sabe cuándo,
so stick it on your wish list.
Square, como que no
correct
va a hacer
me
nada.
If I'm wrong, Brit, but it
no
like
sé.
Going back to back
que le falta
premiers.
Poder a este
I think
evento.
You might be right.
Pero bueno.
We've fished another one out for you guys, and if you ask me, it's whoa, kind of a prize catch. Wow. See what I did there?
Yeah.
I'm hilarious.
I'm hilarious. Dice la Brit. La Tifa Lockhart.
Peggy
pero bueno,
12.
O sea, creo que el Future Game Show este, creo que puede ser el día de hoy lo mejorcito. Pero vamos a ver. Pero seguimos con muchos juegos. Literalmente. Literalmente todo lo que he visto hoy ha sido juego de indie. Pero está mal, pero hola.
Dredge, The Iron Reef, coming August 15th.
Mire, que PlayStation 4 o PlayStation 5. Merece. No sé. No me llama mucho la atención.
Dive back into one of last year's most beloved indie games when Dredge, the Iron Rig, launches on August 15th.
You know, speaking of beloved indies, we are pleased to be launching our very own future game show, Humble Bundle. It features a curated selection
a la verga,
of games
Humble Bundle
that have appeared in our shows
over the years. Show para elegir
so, if you like what you see, head to the URL and name your price, and by doing so, you'll be supporting the developers and Humble's chosen charities.
Back to the trailers now.
Bien.
In this next section, we're spotlighting 7 games to keep on your radar.
7 juegos. Así, de coñazo. Boom. A ver.
Frag your friends with the help of roguelike upgrades in this fast-paced, genre-blending online shooter. Diabolical roguelikes you pick between 3 specializations to cause carnage on the battlefield in hectic 4v4 matchups. It launched in early access on Steam and Epic Games on June 4th, 2024. So, yep, you can play it right now.
Se puede jugar ahora mismo.
Into a narcotics dealer, a dealer into a cartel boss. Find out.
Yo creo que esos juegos
nacen
medio muertos. O sea, ¿quién va a querer jugar eso si está Overwatch,
DDS2 is coming to PC on June 20th, 2024. Keep your eyes on this one, says Local Thunk, developer of breakout hit Bellatro. Star Vaders is a tactical roguelike deck builder where you pilot a mech to defend humanity from an alien scourge. Players can customize their digital decks to take out the intergalactic invaders with Eureka Moment synergies. Star Vaders is coming soon to PC, and you can check out the demo on Steam after the show. Step into the shoes of a plucky airship pilot in Clockwork Ambrosia, a steampunk Metroidvania where the focus is on crafting rule-breaking weapons and armor. Explore gorgeous pixelated worlds to uncover the secrets of a missing civilization, enlisting curious companions and taking down leagues of automatons. Check out the Clockwork Ambrosia demo on Steam today. Turn foes into friends and search for your lost soulmate in Sword of the Necromancer Resurrection, a 3D remake of the 2021 action RPG from Grimorio of Games. A dungeon crawler steeped in mystery, players must level up, collect gear, and recruit fallen enemies to survive in atmospheric environments. Fight past death and twist fate when Sword of the Necromancer Resurrection drops on PC and consoles later this year. Anton Blast is an explosive action platformer inspired by the GBA greats. Race, bounce, and slide your way through surreal, destructible environments, wielding a mighty hammer to bash goons and topple the game's eclectic bosses. Anton Blast is dashing onto Nintendo Switch and PC this November 12th, but there's a Dynamite demo available right now on Steam. Find your new home on the galaxy's edge in Farlands, an intergalactic farming sim with a cozy pixel aesthetic. Chop weeds and build a community as you chart the stars for resources to save your local star system from destruction. Farlands is launching in early access on July 24th, but there's a demo out today on Steam, so you can dive in right after the show. Three hits and you're out. Step into the ring in Big Boy Boxing, a slapstick boss rush adventure inspired by the Punch-Out series. Quirky opponents are brought to life by fluid animations as you bob, weave, and jab your way through the clobbering ranks, learning attack patterns and upgrading your skills to succeed. Big Boy Boxing is coming soon, so make sure it's on your wish lists.
Remember, you can find all of today's games on our dedicated Future Games Show Steam page. Search for Future Games Show on Steam, and you can start digging into the demos and fleshing out your wish lists.
Special delivery! Our friends at Billy Goat Entertainment have sent us a new trailer for Parcel Core, the studio's extreme sports courier simulator. Let's take a look.
El tema de... El wishlist es como que es muy importante.
Hello, judicious viewer. At Billy Goon Entertainment, we are strong believers in the old adage, art from adversity, which is why we've decided, completely of our own volition and certainly not under any form of duress, commit to delivering our new video game, Parcel Core, this
September 3rd.
That's right, on
September 3rd.
Lol. You'll have the opportunity to assume your role in the gig economy, ensuring your board of directors can collect their annual dividends. You'll have to placate a colorful cast of business operators, from florists to medical professionals to leavened fried dough vendors to themed beverage sellers to more themed beverage sellers, enabling you to avoid defaulting your debts for another month.
Bicicleta.
So, please help us. By wishlisting Parcel Core today. And remember, you'll find us in the streets on
September 3rd, 2024.
Como que por qué
Parece un robot. Y sé que está hecho a propósito, pero
we're pleased to reveal that Parcel Core will be coming to PC, Parcel PlayStation Corps. And Xbox on September 3rd, 2024.
Bueno, no es algo que me anime mucho, pero bueno, pero por lo menos me quedo que sale en septiembre 3.
Our next game is a mind-blowing interdimensional platformer where...
Así que a ver, este... No dudo que haya demo, pero... Me llama lo suficiente la atención como para probarlo si hay demo. Pero hay una escalera, pero en el mundo real no hay escalera. Y ahí es como ya una cagadita, ¿no? Ni siquiera en la pantalla pequeña, ni siquiera se ve el portal. Screenbound hubiera sido interesante que tuviera demo, pero bueno.
Screenbound is coming soon, so wishlist it on Steam. And if you think about it, Roger, that's technically two games for the price of one.
It's a steal!
Yeah.
Switching gears now, as we've got a trailer to share from our friends at Netflix.
Ah, los de Netflix.
Here's a look
el juego de Netflix que va a ser
coming to the platform later this
es...
year.
Bueno, es para... móviles también porque es de Netflix y que tenía buena pinta porque al parecer puede ser un game as a service, aunque no creo que sea un game as a service, creo que simplemente está ahí y ya está. Ah no, aquí son un showcase de varios juegos de Netflix, que Netflix está haciendo varios juegos ahora. Vale, contexto, Netflix abrió su departamento de Netflix Games y varios juegos que puedes jugar en la plataforma Netflix si tienes Netflix. Y no son games as a service, porque son juegos pequeñitos que puedes jugar en el Netflix ya sea desde el teléfono o el televisor. Y no tienen microtransacciones ni nada, así que por ese lado...
Resisting temptation will be hard for you.
Bien. Que era este era uno, ¿no? Que creo que es el del problema. Tampoco es que soy muy fan de jugar en Netflix. Pero bueno. Simplemente es como una plataforma más para jugar videojuegos. Así que si pagas Netflix tienes acceso a esto. No es que es un Game Pass, es como un Game Pass, básicamente. Netflix Games. Y aquí se puede entender mejor.
Thank you to Netflix for sending over that trailer.
We've got another world premiere for you now. This game lets you exploit a gang of unruly mercenaries for your own
self-esteem. A ver. Un pollo.
Time to dazzle these idiots.
Hey, my good townsfolk, have I got a story for you. I have tirelessly explored the wilds and found epic loot. I can kick any monster's ass, even the nastiest nightmares. I rip them apart. Even when facing death, I never give up. Why? Because I'm a hero, and I'm here to protect you. Oh, cut the crap! You're no hero! Obviously, they did all the fighting! You fighting? To gain XP? Who needs XP when you're famous?
Y necesita experiencia si eres famoso.
Happy bastards!
Todos luchan por él. En fin, el concepto.
Let me recuerda a lo que era Jutsu del capítulo de Happy Bastards, which is coming soon. What's next, Brit?
We're checking in with the Relic First Guardian, an apocalyptic Souls-like from Project Cloud Games.
Dijo Cloud. A la verga, dijo Cloud. Cloud. The Relic, First Guardian, no sé, man. Me gusta la ambientación. Pero me gusta, no me gusta que la compresión hace que se vea un poco frío. Sin demo tampoco.
The Relic First Guardian is coming soon to PlayStation and PC. What have you got for us all the way over there, Roger?
Well, it's a nice problem to have, but we simply have too many games to show you. So we're going to throw it out to a series of back-to-back trailers and check in with you guys in a little bit.
Works for me. Shall we go grab a drink?
That would not be disagreeable. I hear you make a really good Cosmo Canyon.
Oh, I'd love to whip one up.
Yes, please.
Y que he escuchado que tú haces unos muy buenos Cosmo Canyons. ¿Qué pasaron? Hablando de Cosmo Canyons, quiero probar esa bebida. Vi una video en YouTube de cómo prepararla, por ahí me hago un Cosmo Canyon y a saber qué pasa. Pa pa ra, pa 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 pa. Bueno, no es un Cosmo Canyon, pero es rojo. Así que no está servido en un vaso de vidrio triangular como para tequila. Pero... bueno, tequila, Martín, ¿no? Pero bueno. Salud. Un release October 3rd, 2024. Y este sí tiene un demo, pero creo que ni siquiera me gustó mucho lo que vi. A ver. Es una narrativa aventura. Aventura narrativa, perdón. Tienes que investigar crímenes. O sea, básicamente es como que el juego es que estás en la PC de un policía y tienes que atar cabos, cámara de seguridad, documentos, fingerprints, escuchar notas de voz, no sé qué, y sacar The Operator se llama. No está mal, puede ser, es un puzzle game. De Operator. Creo que me llama la atención porque me recuerda un poco el tema de Phoenix Wright, que también tienes que buscar pista y tal. Vamos a ver.
Peggy 12.
Peggy 12. Que de miedo también. Pero no me gusta la compresión, ¿eh? Hay que ver la diferencia entre un directo y un video. Y está subida a 4K, que de paso es un fake direct que hacen algunas. Delivers us home, pero ajá, no me explicas qué coño es el juego, para ver si me interesa.
So the funny thing is that his name actually was Lenny, so he thought everyone was screaming about him, going, Lenny!
Okay.
Oh, welcome back!
Hi, did you enjoy those trailers?
Good. Clarisa, que están haciendo súper a propósito, no, o sea, no es real, no es que,
oh, pasó, trailer for the precinct.
Sino que está todo hecho a propósito. Ah, pasó esto. Quiero ser como más cozy, más como real, más como cercano. Como que, ah, perdón, aquí estamos. Pero se notó la reacción de...
Stick to your beat, and maybe, just maybe, you'll get to retirement in one piece like me.
You, stop there.
We got him in handcuffs, dispatch. 10-4, aerial unit inbound. Central, be advised, suspect missed spikes. Central to all units, bank robbery in progress.
Cough him up, Boot.
Tienes que capturar criminales en The Present. El Presidio. Persecuciones policiales. Pero eres el policía, no eres el convicto, que siempre es el que maneja.
All right, kid. You did good today. I'll see you in the morning.
Se mandó un hot dog de un bocado, ¿eh?
Bloom. That was The Precinct, which is coming to PC, PlayStation, and Xbox on August 15th, 2024.
Esto es un juego que se puede perfectamente jugar en Switch, no sé qué cada jota.
If you like to try before you buy, then good news. Every game in this next section has a demo attached that you can play after the show.
Days are coming. Todos los juegos que vas a ver aquí son, tienen demos attached. Vamos a ver.
My turn.
Vamos pues. Future Game Show wants to play. El Motor Boom.
First up is Motor Dude, a gnarly BMX roguelike that blends Tony Hawk's Pro Skater with Vampire Survivors.
Okay. ¿Qué más?
Next up is Angeline Era, a non-linear adventure game where you dodge traps and bump slash enemies to save an ancient world.
Here's 10 Dead Doves, a psychological horror game where you seek out an urban legend in the Appalachian wilderness.
Servonauts is next, a couch co-op party game where you wield wobbly pipes to manage the galaxy's most chaotic gas station.
Design the future in Dystopica, a cozy cyberpunk city builder where you can create
un creador de ciudades cyberpunkianas. Okay.
Next in line is Gun Touchables, a co-op roguelite where teams of
preppers
repel an evolving mutant invasion.
And this is Wild Bastards, a rootin' tootin' roguelike shooter where you manage a crew of intergalactic outlaws. Last but not least,
ay, ¿por qué no
this
lo
is Metal Suits,
no lo dice
running
ella?
Gun space shooter starring one. A cyborg veteran out for revenge.
Tenía que decir ella, no tú, por favor.
Head to the Future Games Show Steam page to find all those demos and everything else featured in today's show.
Rip, I've got someone I'd like you to meet. Goes by the name of Eugene McQuacklin. They're a private eye. Following the breadcrumbs of a foul salami scheme.
A duck detective? Please, say no more.
The truth. The truth is an ugly mistress. But I ain't no duckling.
Hi, I'm Johnny.
And I'm Monica. And we're from Happy Broccoli Games.
Right now, we're from Duck Detective, the Secret Salami. But solving crime is no walk in the pond. You are a down-on-his-luck detective who also happens to be a duck.
Duck. Not able to pay next month's rent.
Use your powers of deduction to inspect evidence, fill in the blanks, and bust the case wide open in a narrative mystery adventure that's not quite as it seems.
Everyone has a motive or a secret.
Duck Detective is a 2 to 3 hour long mystery game that's inspired by games like Return of the Obra Dinn and Case of the Gold Idol. The game is fully voiced and, of course, it has a dedicated quiet button.
No me gusta mucho cómo se ve, entonces. Más que nada, el pato que hace.
Today we're really excited to share with you the Duck Detective is coming to mobile later this year.
Now you can already play Duck Detective on Steam and Switch.
Hay un
thanks
demo,
for watching,
entonces,
and hope you enjoy the rest of the
si
show.
Si lo puedes jugar, es que hay un demo. Uy, perfecto.
I'm a different duck now. I haven't had a slice of bread in weeks.
Soy
duck
un
detective,
pato diferente.
The Secret Salami.
Duck Detective, The Secret Salami, is out now on PC and Nintendo Switch.
No, no tiene demo. Simplemente ya está listo, ya está fuera.
This next trailer is for the RPG fans out there. Sacrifier is inspired by the 90s classics and features a soundtrack composed by Motui Sakuraba.
Ajá, yo creo que ahorita que estaba haciendo la comida vi algo de esto. Un juego RPG con la música de Motui Sakuraba, creadores de música como los de Tales of, de ¿cómo se llama? Valkyrie Profile. Entre otros. Me gusta la música.
Ezekiel, the dome is under attack. You must retrieve from Alcora.
Pero el gameplay, a ver, ¿sabes? De momento no está mal, tiene que parecer como un... Ay, ¿cómo se llama este juego? Octopath Traveler.
Statues coming to life. Am I
dreaming? El combate es así como tipo tel, o sea, tipo real, pues. You'll get what you deserve.
Damn it.
No está mal.
Where did the thief go?
Give me the map. Yo un poco más el tema del pixelar, pero bueno, no tengo. Porque ahorita más en una época que conoce pixelar. Pero siempre lo quieren dejar con ese toque antiguo, ¿sabes? Pero se pueden hacer pixel, porque he jugado juegos con pixel art que se ven muy nítidos, ¿no? Como cristales. Cristales creo que tiene ese pixel art que me gusta. Pero bueno, no está mal este jueguito.
Sacrifier is coming soon.
Sacrifier.
Playtest just went live on Steam. If you want to try it out before launch. I feel like it's time we add another game to our yearbook, right, Brit?
I think that's a good idea. You know what? More than a decade later, we're finally getting a sequel to Warhammer 40K Space Marine.
Warhammer Space Marine, Space Marine tiene secuela ahora.
And here's everything you need to know about it.
Nothing will survive our wrath.
Chainswords at the ready, because Warhammer 40K Space Marine 2 is staining the pages of our Ones to Watch yearbook with gallons of Xeno's blood. Space Marine 2 is the hotly anticipated follow-up to Relic Entertainment's 2011 third-person shooter. Helmed by Saber Interactive this time around,
no
Space
mal.
Marine 2 promises even more guts and glory
pero
for
no sé,
three
solo,
players across its galactic co-op
ser.
Campaign.
Como dice
you
gente,
are dropped into the clanking,
no,
capable boots of Lieutenant Dimitrian Titus, voiced by Clive Standen
uno,
of Vikings fame.
Delta Wing,
como hay un montón de fanbase que yo como que hay, entonces.
There's no way through.
Get into assault position by the bridge.
Pero me refiero que se ve comprimido así feito, pero bueno. A lo que sea con la calidad del stream.
Titus is a true space marine, the Emperor's personal angel of death, a stoic ultramarine with a penchant for defending the Imperium. Though at the start of the game, he's dealing with the aftermath of a suspicious demotion and an even more pressing existential matter. The Terranid scourge threatening mankind. Space Marine 2 will transport players to the front lines of the Fourth Tyrannic War, with hundreds of creatures coating the screen as you trudge through the biomes of perilous planets. From Terranid warriors, Hormigaunts, gargoyles, and quite likely much larger foes, you'll be overwhelmed in short order if you and your team don't keep your wits about you. The grisly combat blends over-the-shoulder shooting with a deep melee brawling system, allowing you to parry, dodge, pull off brutal combos, and execute your enemies to top up armor supplies.
You will pay, you rotten cowards!
It's a metal maelstrom of chaotic conflict, and we're excited to see what Titus and the gang will face up against when the game launches later this year. Space Marine 2 is coming to PlayStation, Xbox, and PC on the 9th of September, so there's still plenty of time to scrub up on the wealth of 40K lore before you suit up and ship out on this gnarly Warhammer adventure.
Space Marine, Warhammer 14,000.
Warhammer 40K Space Marine 2 is coming to PC, PlayStation, and Xbox on September 9th, 2024. We still have one more game to add to our yearbook, so keep an eye out.
Before we get to that, though, how about another world premiere?
Yeah. Okay. But, you know, I have to admit, this is a bit of a wild one. I think it needs a Wrangler's touch, just... Give me a second.
A la broma.
Whoa! Easy now. You're all right. You're all right. Stop it! Stop it! Oh, you... Oh, just one second.
Ok, dos juegos. El que sea que van a presentar ahora y el último, que quizás sea totalmente solo, quizás es una decepción y no va a estar. Ya está. ¿Esto qué es? ¿Qué es esto? ¿Por qué hay una cabra? No me digas que es Goat Simulator otra vez. 4 y verga. Ahora, no, 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 ahora Goat Simulator 2, porque como no sacaron el 2 sino el 3, ahora hay que Goat Simulator 2, ¿te imaginas? Es Goat Simulator esta verga. Es Goat Simulator, merdicia. Pero ¿cuál? ¿2 o 4? Yo no sé, yo tomo este juego, pero me da risa los trailers. Es una guachapa, jugar, una guachapa, jugar este juego. Ajá, Goat Simulator, ¿qué? Hay tres opciones. Que digan Goat Simulator 2, Goat Simulator 4, o se saltan el 4 y Goat Simulator 5. Ya no sé qué pensar. Pues expansión del 2, del 3. Ah, no, es el 3 con Multiverse of Nonsense DLC. No sé por qué. En fin, de la, yo tenía tres opciones y es una cuarta que no había pensado, un DLC.
Go toe to toe with Capybara Thanos.
Oye, entonces tiene sentido que hubiera un 4 tan pronto porque no se sacaron el 3, así que.
A brand new DLC pack for Goat Simulator 3. It's coming to PC, PlayStation, and Xbox on the 19th of June. And you can wishlist it now on Steam.
By the way, if you're enjoying the show, you can let us know.
Head to the link on screen now and fill in the survey to be in with the chance of winning some great prizes courtesy of MSI.
All right, time for something completely different. This year, the Future Games Show is launching a new initiative to help increase the visibility of up-and-coming indie games.
We've created a video submission form so that game makers from around the world can pitch their projects to the show in a snappy 45-second format. A link to the form should be on the screen now.
Think of it as an indie elevator pitch. In the coming weeks and months, we'll share the submissions on social media and highlight them during our upcoming live shows.
To give you an idea of what we're looking for, the FGS team handpicked some of the most anticipated indie games and asked the developers to create their own elevator
pitch. But other cosa es esto, que más seguro te lo ponen tipo video o algo así en la página web. Entonces, si tú entras en la página, lo puedes ver.
Welcome to the world of Schim. My name is Ewout. I'm one of the developers of the game, and I'm responsible for the programming and art.
Es una criatura. Esto es un juego de una criatura que es una sombra que tiene que estar en.
In Schim, you jump from shadow to shadow. You play as a little shadow creature that goes separate from the person, and now it's up to you to find your way back. Along the way, you will also help other Schim that have lost their objects. We will release a PlayStation 4, 5, Xbox, Nintendo Switch, and Steam. Get ready to hop around on July 18th.
Está curioso el concepto.
I'm Kurt Olsen, the creator of the upcoming stealth comedy game.
Hola, ¿cómo estás? Yo anda.
World's Worst Candyman.
Al stream. Estamos viendo aquí.
I'm also a father of three with a full-time day job.
Future of Game Showcase.
5 years ago, I taught myself to code acabar, and make games in my spare time.
Estamos viendo los Wholesome Direct, el
World's Worst Candyman combines my love for stealth horror with the charm
y el Future
of Nintendo
Play Show.
Games. It's a thrilling stealth comedy game for
ayer
all
vimos
ages.
El Game Fest,
you play as Doug,
an
unskilled handyman trying to save his local animal shelter
y mañana
from
viene
bankruptcy.
El Xbox Show,
find tools,
PC gaming show,
complete tasks, avoid angry residents, and earn enough money to save the shelter. World's Worst Handyman
bienvenido.
Releases this September. Play the
aunque
free
la
demo
es que la mayoría
and wishlist
indie,
the game on Steam.
No, no
me pasa
nada porque me gustan los indies, pero no todos. Thanks. Y hay como muy
Judoro is a stop-motion action-adventure game set in a mystical historic Scotland. We are a dedicated and passionate two-man team making a truly independent game without compromise.
Pero bueno, vamos a ver.
In Judoro, you will explore a world full of eccentric stories and crafted NPCs.
El Summer Game Fest ayer dijeron.
You will overcome challenges with Judoro's combat and possession mechanics. Our favorite part is perhaps the varied and sometimes grotesque bosses the game is replete with. Judoro is coming out this autumn on Steam. Please wishlist and help spread the word. Thank you.
No sé qué tan indie sea, pero el de
Metal Slug.
Hey, Future Game Show. Those guys over there are Heavy Lunch Studio.
Tactics.
And they've known each other for like 100 years. And in an act of hubris and self-delusion, they decided to make their first video game, Hermit and Pig. It's an adventure RPG about a reclusive old man and his truffle-hunting pig. These two unlikely heroes get drawn into a dangerous conspiracy involving evil corporations, unusually violent animals, hungry townspeople, cultist weirdos, and a giant mythical mushroom. You'll have to dig deep and ask yourself important questions like, can I master the self-defense techniques necessary to survive? Can I overcome my social anxiety to become a hero? And should I really eat every mushroom I find? You can find these answers and more in Hermit and Pig.
Que me llamó la atención,
the demo is available on Steam now.
Han sido así indies, pero de terror, no sé. Tengo aquí notado algunos cuantos.
Thank you.
Algunos tienen demo y quizá los probamos después.
Helped us launch this brand new section. Make sure you wishlist Judero, Hermit and Pig, World's Worst Handyman, and Skim on Steam.
And if you're a game maker who wants to participate in the Indie Elevator Pitch, you can find out more using the link on screen right now. Show us what you got.
Básicamente, es un nuevo movimiento que me gusta, que si tú eres un creador, puedes lanzar
means another world premiere. This one's a stealth strategy adventure game set
tu
in an impressive cityscape.
Sin tanto problema, porque en otras circunstancias tendrías que hablar con ellos bien, no sé qué, pagar, no sé qué. Aquí es como que metes la vaina, yo lo reviso y si tal, lo subo. Otro juego. Pero yo pensé que había un último juego, ¿no? Como que al parecer el show continúa, bien. ¿Y esto? Cámara tipo SOCOM, top down. ¿Qué más? ¿De qué va?
We just want to talk to him.
We're just going to talk to him.
You told me you wanted out. You and your brother. You said you're done with this. It's too dangerous. Not what you wanted.
Find her. She's here somewhere.
I respected your decision because I thought you respected me and my business and everything I've done for you.
This isn't about me.
Oh, it's always about you, Hannah. And now you've brought the police here.
They're looking for Herman.
Okay, me gusta que hay como una trama.
Look, I have no idea what
he's
done. I don't care. I've just got to find him before they do.
The stealth, pero no sé hasta qué punto. Si hay algún tipo de combate y tal.
You've set things in motion you don't understand, Hannah.
Reach. The Stolen Dream, el sueño robado. No está tan mal. O sea, me parece curioso la narrativa.
Eric's Home, The Stolen Dream, is coming
Eric's
soon to PC
Holmes,
and consoles. What's next, Roger?
Well, here's a closer look at Run from Mummies, a cooperative dungeon crawler where you play a group of plucky tourists dodging traps to photograph ancient relics.
A ver. Tiene pinta que no me va a llamar la atención para nada. Tomar fotografías de antiguas reliquias, pero no soy muy fan de los snaps games. Aunque me da risa.
Well, the sights are unforgettable and rife with dangers.
Ah, bueno, pero básicamente esto es un gameplay de esquivar, no sé qué. La excusa es tomar fotos, pero la idea es esquivar trampas y cosas. Mientras haces esa gran.
So, take plenty of pictures. Find souvenirs.
Bueno, puede estar curioso. Y creo que se puede jugar con 5 personas. Se lo hace más curioso todavía. O sea, creo que puede estar bien. Me arrepiento de lo que dije. Y parece medio Fatal Frame porque el tomar fotos pues como que hace daño a los enemigos, ¿verdad? Y también como que interactúa con el guard.
One last piece of advice. Run from mummies.
Run from mummies. Corre de las momias. Capa de las momias.
Yes, buy it.
Blast, is this recording still up?
Bueno, no está mal el jueguito.
Run from Mummies is coming to PC and PS5 in fall 2024. And you can play the demo on Steam after the show.
Up next, we've got a Souls-like side-scroller set in a dark fantasy world.
Here's the latest update on Mandragora. Steam, así que bien.
Take me forward, no matter the danger.
Esto se ve bueno, esto parece Metroidvania side-scrolling.
Hi everyone, Alex here, Community Marketing Manager at Primal Game Studio. We're currently working on our most ambitious game to date, Mandragora. Mandragora is a 2.5D action RPG side-scroller with deep Metroidvania and Souls-like elements. We're currently working on fine-tuning the many features that will be available in the game, including epic 3D boss fights and a branching talent tree.
Inquisitor, got a prize for your journey upstairs. You deserve better for what you did to that witch, but it's all we've got to spare.
In the full release, expect to find yourself immersed in a narrative crafted by industry legend Brian Mitsoda, known for his work on Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Meet many characters, all voiced by professional voice actors, including Aisha Salim, known for her work on Overwatch, and find yourself whisked away into the world of Mandragora with a dark fantasy soundtrack composed by Christos Antonio, best known for his work as a member of Sectic Flesh. ...2024 is going to be a big year for us, as we work towards releasing later this year alongside our new publishing partner, Knights Peak. We look forward to bringing Mandragora to your PC and consoles, and really hope you enjoy playing.
Ahí demo.
Your passenger is lost, so is this world.
Mandragora from new publisher, Knights Peak, is coming to PC and consoles later this year.
We're taking a look at Duskborn now. Red Thread Games Road Trip Adventure. Here's the latest trailer.
They've got their lights on.
Ah, este es el juego. Creo que este es el juego de música rara. No, o es otro. Calm down.
Take a deep breath, Sai. Let's pull over. We can handle the police. Pax, maybe put the cargo in a safe place.
Handle the police? How exactly?
You know what cops do to people like us.
Sai. Please, listen to me.
Says the woman who never listens to anyone!
We're so dead!
Stop the car! Es un juego de tomar decisiones narrativo
así. We'll
handle
the cops.
Roll down your window. Huh?
What?
The window, the window.
Oh, wait.
Hey, hello. Hi, officer. What's going on?
I'll need you people to step out of the vehicle.
You're a loser. How badly did you screw up to get here? Highway patrol in the middle of nowhere?
I was doing just fine, deviant, until you tried to mess with my head. I said, exit the vehicle.
Hey, officer, walk out the road into the.
A la broma, se le llevó un camión.
Road.
Jesus, fuck.
Ay, Dios mío.
Drive. Drive, Sai, now.
Yeah, you and me.
Stop him.
Fue tan interesante este jueguito. Simplemente por las locuras de tomar las tomas de decisiones.
Duskborn is coming to PC, PlayStation, and Xbox on August 20th,
2024. Pero bueno,
all right, wish list at the ready, folks, because we've got a sweep of exciting trailers coming up next.
Exciting up trailers. Vamos a ver. Y decir una cosa. Todos los años he tenido juegos, pero yo recuerdo que había una mezcla algo homogénea y tal. Entre juegos indie y juegos un poco más tal. Es que ahora siento que hay muchos juegos indie por demasiar. Y juegos más grandes como que muy pocos. Ya no digo triple A, sino más grandes, doble A aunque sea. Muy pocos. Y está raro, la verdad.
Y creo que tiene que ver con eso, de que prácticamente no hay juegos para mostrar. Fuck. Todas son así.
Pero bueno.
Y los juegos indie que estoy esperando, que quiero ver, no me los muestran. Y es como que no jodas. Un poco triste la vaina. A ver. ¿Qué más?
Ah, the majestic Albertown, last known bastion of civilization and progress. Become one of our esteemed engineers, and let the illumination of our great leader, William Kane, guide you. Today is your day. Join our annual lottery and plug into your true potential. Prove your worth and ascend to greatness inside Albatross Technologies.
And then she says, I'll be fine. You've seen how much ass I can kick.
Ah, damn!
A la broma, Tifa hablando ahí.
No, you're back! Let's keep up the pace and jump straight into our next trailer.
Pneumata. Pneumata. Pragmata, pero mal. No sé, pero es de terror, así que me...
Did you notice that rope tied around his neck? No. Never mind.
Me gusta. Incredible Atmospheres Fandom Wire. El Fandom Wire es el que dice eso, ¿no? Atmosphere increíble. First Person Horror Atmosphere Game. Malo disparando, ese soy yo disparando ahí.
What he made me do it.
Vale, sí.
You shouldn't be here.
Pneumata is a suburban survival horror game.
Literalmente la pela quita, Pneumata.
It's coming to PC and consoles in 2024.
Y no hay demo.
Our next game takes influence from Hotline Miami and fuses Japanese mythology with contemporary hip hop. Feast your eyes on Sono Kuni.
Este le gustó a Kai, creo. Da ulti kai. Japonesa. No sé qué coño va el juego, pero la música está buena. Sono Kuni. Kuni, la vaina.
Sono Kuni is a top-down action game from the Danyasa crew, a hip-hop group from Japan that decided to make their own indie game. It's coming soon to PC, but for now, you can wishlist it on Steam.
Eternal Strands is up next, an action game where you use magic, weapons, and climbing skills to take down enormous monsters. Here's the latest trailer.
Okay. Aha. Shadow of the Colossus vibes.
So after all the legends, this is it. The Enclave.
El Enclave.
Bryn, you need to get out of there, now.
I was made for this, Aurea.
Yellow Brigade.
We've known about this safe zone in the Vale's shadow for decades. No one's been this close in years. My hope is that we're going to find artifacts from the Enclave itself deeper into the shadow.
You can count on me. Épica. Lo puedes escalar a los Shadow Colossus. O sea, este me gusta. Así que... Explora, caza. También puedes cazar. Algo que en Shadow no se puede hacer. Como que la mecánica de Shadow, pero ampliada al millón con más fuerza. Trastea. Como dice, Mobile Game. A ver. Este sí.
This place holds mysteries beyond our wildest dreams. It's time to uncover them.
Eternal Strongs.
Eternal Strands is coming soon, Brands. But if you're eager for more, we'll okay. be airing an interview with the developers Líneas, during our official post-show, the Future Games Show Expansion Pack.
The Expansion Pack airs directly after the Summer Showcase, so stick around for a closer look at today's games. Extra World Premieres.
For this next section, the FGS team handpicked some of the most exciting Unreal Engine 5 projects to provide an eye-popping glimpse into the future. Let's check it out.
Los juegos más prometedores de Unreal Engine próximamente. Vamos a ver si son los más prometedores. Pero no sé si son los más prometedores solamente a nivel visual. Water Temple Cell, digamos. O también a nivel de gameplay. Aunque solamente son como conceptos. O sea, por lo que veo, estoy solamente el personaje y tal, un ambiente. Yo juego a Victor Corper, pero por ejemplo, no es. Un juego. Quizás son proyectos de un juego, no sé. No entendí bien esa parte. Pero la verdad es que son bien bonitos. Con la música. Pam. 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 O sea, el cambio ahí. Bueno, son bastante interesantes los escenarios. ¿Son conceptos o son juegos en desarrollo? Es lo que no me queda claro. Jornadas, packages. Creo que son conceptos. A la vez, los escorpiones matándose. Se ve mal. O sea, el poder del Unreal Engine 5.
Thank you to the developers who participated in our Unreal Engine 5 showcase.
Es un showcase.
Be sure to follow them on social media to keep up with these projects as they evolve.
Now, as we all know, the only good bug is a dead bug.
And there's been plenty of virtual pest control going on this year.
But how about some more? Mm. Up next, we have a juicy update on Starship Troopers Extermination.
Starship
Hi,
Trooper
I'm Pierre
Extermination.
I'm the project lead for Starship Troopers Extermination. I'm here to tell you a little bit about the exciting new update coming
divers,
to the game
Troopers,
Courage
hola,
on
no,
Planet
no.
X-11.
Estoy aquí. Soy
the Carnage Trooper. System itself is basically persistent bug bodies everywhere in the world. They don't
vale.
go away.
Helldivers.
Bringing the movie into the video game. Being able to climb on top of the bug clouds to get the best vantage point over the bugs It's a system that we've developed in-house from the ground up. It's really all about bringing carnage in the war to show the persistent damage throughout the world. I'm so excited to share it with the community. Planet X-11 is deep within the Tibanus system in the Arachnid quarantine zone. We're setting this planet within the rings of a gas giant. It's draped in mystery. We are going there to defend the T-Fang array. It's the most important listening post in the Federation and is crucial to Federation operations that we secure it. Planet X-11 is our first attempt in Starship Troopers to combine indoor combat environments with outdoor combat environments. Planet X-11 offers us an opportunity to see what battling the bugs inside Federation buildings is really like. Weak point's something we've really been excited to finally bring into the game. We've added armor to our bugs. And the weak point on the bugs is where you can easily take down a bug if you know how to aim with the right weapon. Weak points add in some more nuance and more depth into gunplay, and that's what weak points are allowing us to do. Working on Starship Troopers Extermination has been a dream come true for me. It's something that I really enjoy coming and working on every day. Being able to bring those movie moments into a video game for the rest of the world to experience has been so much fun.
Para lo que veo que este Starship Troopers se encuentra, o sea, se...
Grab your friends and suit up in Starship Troopers Extermination, which is available now on Steam.
We're following up on that bombshell with our third and final yearbook edition. Let's throw it over to Supermassive Games and Behavior Interactive for a deep dive into the casting of Frank Stone.
Okay, Supermassive Games, cuidado. A ver, ¿qué nos tiene? The casting of Frank Stone. Puede ser que me llame la atención.
From the minds behind Dead by Daylight and the Dark Pictures anthology, please welcome the casting of Frank Stone into our future game show Wants to Watch Yearbook. This single-player horror adventure lets you define your own story in the expanded world of the iconic action horror game Dead by Daylight. Players follow an ensemble of intrepid young filmmakers as they set out to film their own home movie at a murder site steeped in tragic history. Prepare to be posed with fate-changing choices, challenging puzzles, and death-defying QTEs as you guide the cast through eerie environments and shocking twists, dodging grisly deaths along the way. The casting of Frank Stone is coming to PS5, Xbox Series S and X, and PC in 2024. And to give you a closer look at this exciting collaboration, let's throw it over to our friends at Behavior Interactive and Supermassive Games.
Supermassive, cuéntanos cosas.
For the longest time on Dead by Daylight, we knew that we wanted to offer different types of experience to our players. And a single player narrative experience is definitely one of them. And our fans have been requesting it quite a lot. So obviously, Supermassive Games, with their pedigree, their portfolio of game, is the perfect partner to deliver that fantastic horror experience.
Yeah, but the casting of Frank Stone is a classic Supermassive cinematic adventure game. It's an unashamed horror experience. It's a story that we've been thinking around for quite a long time, and it really fits the omniverse idea that underpins a lot of the Dead by Daylight lore, and so it kind of slipped together as a very natural fit.
It all starts with our 1963 storyline, which is investigation of a missing child, which leads us into a very dark, quite grisly serial killer horror story. But as the story unfolds from there, things go in different directions, and we bring in a lot of different subgenres of horror.
Think that belongs to the boy you're looking for?
The main influences were always to try to be the mystic, something you could actually believe happens, something that you can understand, relate to. At the same time, part of it you don't understand and it creates a mystery. We're always going back to the classic slasher horror movies and characters that we learn to love and hate at the same time.
What?
One thing we really latched onto quickly was the idea of how a piece of creative art could become a vehicle for horror. And in our case, that's a Super 8 film that's been made by a group of teenage characters on the site of an infamous serial killer's crimes. That felt like a vehicle where we could bring in other influences of horror that we really like.
Either of you heard of Murder Mail?
Right at the start of the project, talking with Supermassive, we connected because we're passionate about horror and we basically get our inspiration from the same sources. So it was great talking with them and seeing that a lot of the sources for inspiration they're using have been the same that we've been looking into at the genesis of Dead by Daylight. So in that sense, our fans and also new players that will experience this can see that both titles are from the same lineage. So for fans of Supermassive games that still haven't stepped into the fog of Dead by Daylight, this is going to be a great first step.
Come on, people, we got a movie to make.
The
casting of Frank Stone is coming later this year. And with that, we've wrapped up our Ones to Watch yearbook for the summer showcase. Go team!
It also means we're closing in on the end of the show. But that doesn't mean that we're done with the world premieres. Here's one more!
One more world premiere. Okay, puede ser Tormenta del Sol o puede ser cualquier vaina. No, no es Tormenta del Sol.
It's nice.
O sea, adiós Tormenta del Sol y adiós el Taki. Posiblemente lo vemos mañana, pero
only that annoying mongoose always ruins.
Poco decepcionado con eso porque te lo juro que había escuchado que iba a sacar la demo de
Taki. You and your friends can't stop me.
Tormenta del Sol y Tormenta del Sol, pues está casi seguro que llega mañana porque para este año. Algo podría haber mostrado este año, algo podría haber mostrado aunque sea en la final. Da un poco de temor de que no se en serio, el announcement es este. Un Crash Bandicoot en esteroides con su hermano en esteroides. Con monturas. Ok. Claro, no se siente mal, pero no es lo que está esperando como el bombazo. O sea, no se ve mal el jueguito. ¿Cómo te esperas que pase? Bueno, hasta cierto punto. Pero sí. La diferencia es que está siendo casi cierto con la hermana, pero yo no me la parte de cuestión del cookie que hay que hacer. En vez de manzana tiene unas cosas amarillas, no las hay. Nico de Rico. The Magical World.
Nico de Rico is an all-new mascot platformer from developer
mascot
Via Games as part of the new publishing label Knights Peak, which was announced today. It's coming soon to PC and consoles.
No está mal,
you might have seen our next game before. It blew up on social media for its hyper-realistic graphics. Here's the latest trailer for Bodycam.
Pero me dijeron el último tráiler y siguen habiendo tráileres. ¿Qué es esto? Me están engañando. Juegan con mis sentimientos. Bueno, un juego de terror llamado Bodycam. Pues está muy interesante para streamear. Bomb has been implanted. First person shooter.
First person shooter, por lo que veo.
Se vio un excelente trailer. Acá. De terror. Como por lo menos lo que entiendo, ¿no? Por lo menos, que no. Está llamando la atención con el setting al principio, pero creo que no me voy a echar para atrás. No es lo que estaba esperando. Así que Goodbye Bodycam. Y ya está disponible para la gente que le interese.
Bodycam is out now on Steam, so go check it out.
All right, it's time for our final trailer.
Final trailer.
And keeping a tradition, this one is a super special world premiere.
But before we super wrap special things up, world premiere. I have one small question for you, Roger Clark. Aerith or Tifa?
Aerith or Tifa? Aerith or Tifa? Aerith or Tifa?
That's interesting. I feel like that's kind of a loaded question in this scenario.
Oh, no. It's just a hypothetical, you know? There's no wrong answers.
No hay una respuesta equivocada.
Well, like, see, that's really interesting, you know?
It's taking you a long time to answer this.
Well, if I had to choose between Tifa and Aerith, I think I would have to go with...
Está bueno. Me gustó eso de que jueguen con Aerith o Tifa. Tifa o Aerith. Me gusta un Cosmocan y no sé qué verga. Está bueno. Es muy difícil de. Perdón, me gusta como. Me da risa como Yuffie y la ignoran para que no vaya a definirme quién es Yuffie. A ver, Woodrunner Games.
Todo. That was a quick taste of what's to come from Woodrunner Games. An indie studio featuring developers who worked on Cuphead and Rick and Morty.
The game's full reveal is expected later this year.
Which would coincide with the next Future Games show. Interesting. Brett, I hate to say goodbye, but that's a wrap on the Summer Showcase.
Oh, man. You know what, though? I'm just glad we got to do this together. We were outlaws to the end.
Damn right we were.
Y mira, thanks for sharing the stage. Tenía el top blanco y la falda negra. O sea, estaba medio Tifa incógnito.
Don't leave just yet, cowboy. Because we've got the post-show coming up right after this with more trailers and deep dives on the way.
There'll also be tons of follow-up content on GamesRadar.com and our FGS social channels on YouTube and TikTok.
Finally, before we take off, we'd also like to thank the hardworking developers. Trailer makers,
bueno,
PR representatives, and everyone.
No sé, across the ¿qué hacemos? ¿Malo o bueno? Porque tengo que elegir ahora si el evento fue malo o bueno.
We couldn't have done it without you.
Me gustaron algunas cosas, pero esperaba más. Así que voy a ponerle malo.
And check out some of the demos we discussed. I know we mention it a lot, but your wish lists go a long way. So, if you like a project, go ahead and show it.
I'm Roger Clark.
And I'm Britt Barron.
Britt Barron
has been the Future Game Show Summer Showcase 2024.
Bueno, gente.
Great job.
Se acabó el Future. Mira, bien. Expansion Pack starts in 15 seconds. Game Expansion Pack. Okay, no lo sé, pero vamos a verlo. Future Game Show se acabó. Un poco decepcionante porque no tuvieron las dos cosas que estaba esperando. Pero unos cuantos proyectos interesantes. No sé, pero claro, si lo veo con ojo de que no hay ningún triple A, ya. Pero mierda.
Hello, friends, and welcome to the Future Game Show Expansion Pack, the official post show of the summer.
Pero lo que voy a hacer es que hago así y voy a pasarme a pantalla así, ¿vale? Que esté un poco de fondo mientras hablo. Y bueno, básicamente, señores, El evento, siento que, ok, no tuvo triple A. Si lo juzgo como eso, fue una mierda. Pero tuvo algunos juegos interesantes. Pero ¿qué pasa? Lo digo porque en episodios anteriores de años pasados, el Future Game Show siempre mostraba alguna cosa mayor. O sea, indies, claro, pero también dobles A's interesantes. Y de repente algún triple A así de la nada. Poquito, ¿no? Pero más que, no sé. Pero es que ahora fue indie y doble A. Es literalmente no sé cuál podrá ser doble A de todo esto. Creo que el único, el casting Frank Stone, que bueno, que eso, por más Massive Game, quizás es un triple A de su estilo, pero tampoco a nivel gráfico estaba al nivel de un juego de Dark Pictures, así que no sé. Es que había muchas cosas que me llamaban la atención, pero que eran todas súper... Mandragora puede estar interesante también, pero son puros juegos muy muy indie, o sea, no sé. Entonces, esto en cuanto a esto. Ahora, el resto de eventos en general, lo de Women's Wholesome y tal, pero Women's Led y el Wholesome Direct, y el que no vi en vivo, percibí un poquito de pedacitos el Feature Play. Siento que estuvo un poco decepcionante en general. El evento esperaba más, en general. Pero bueno, a ver qué pasa mañana. Yo por lo pronto me despido. Quería ver si jugaba ahorita más tarde el tema de bien sea de continuar con el Treasure Hunting de Final Fantasy 7 Rebirth, que me faltan 3 trofeos. O darle a Stellar Blade, pero la verdad es que tengo que hacer algunas cositas antes, así que no sé si me desconecto ahorita y hago esas cosas, o lo dejo ya para mañana, y regreso más tarde, o lo dejo para mañana para continuar con los jueguitos, que mañana tenemos que vernos para ver el Xbox y el PC Gaming Show, además, a ver si me falta algún otro, y el de Ubisoft es literalmente el lunes. Así que pues nada, yo por lo pronto me despido, y si regreso para darle al tema de jugar, lo haré, pero mientras tanto, de momento nos vemos en la próxima, pero primero vamos a elegir voy lamentablemente a dejarlo con un rate negativo. Tenía preparado más o menos con dos botones del OBS. Si me gustaba, tenía una cosa, y si no me gustaba, tenía otra. Entonces, la verdad es que estoy en mid-review, no tengo el del medio, así que de momento pongo el facepalm. Así que, como siempre, nos vemos en la próxima.
Si te ha gustado lo que has visto acá, deja un me gusta y apóyame dándole al botón de suscribir para no perderte de mi contenido.